Okay, so today I was gonna go and do some machining here, but Mother Nature decided otherwise. So now we need to clear some snow before we can even get to the garage. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Okay, so now I have recovered the cargo, made my way up this hill. So yeah, I delivered this a few days ago here in minus 23 degrees Celsius weather, so yeah, it took some battery to get it here. But yeah, now to just get it down to the garage. So today we're not at my normal shop, we're taking a detour so that we can process this 8mm thick steel. We're gonna be plasma cutting it into some more manageable pieces because this piece is humongous. It weighs over 200 kilograms. So yeah, first order of business is to cut this one up into more manageable pieces. Let's go. So the first thing that I did was to create some CAD templates of the EM57 motor and the SR6 gearbox. So this will help us to see how much of a piece we're gonna have to cut out. Perfekt. Den är rykande het. Ok, can see where it started to go south. We're gonna swap out the nozzle now. This part is done! Yeah, so here are the plates now, completed. I'm just gonna go take an angle grinder and clean them up, especially the bigger one. It got a bit, yeah, I don't know what's going on there, but yeah, we'll clean them up now. So yeah, safety glasses, hearing aid. Okay, so now the piece is a bit safer to touch, so yeah, I'll just continue off camera with the final one, and then we can start drilling some holes. So before cleaning up the plates anymore, I'm gonna drill some holes to get them to line up. So I'm gonna start here with the gearbox side, and I'm gonna be using the dowels, the guiding dowels or guiding pins that are on the gearbox, and I'm gonna start with drilling these out. So to get this somewhat accurate, I'm using some paint, and I'm just dotting them and then smashing the plate against it and hoping that enough paint will transfer for me to make a pilot hole. Yeah, let's go. So, this is what it now looks like with those both pilot holes drilled. The gearbox is lining up extremely well with this piece of steel. So, now that this piece will not move anymore, it is time to drill out the main bolt holes to hold it in place. Yeah, some more drilling. Wish me luck! So someone might ask themselves, why didn't I just use this one instead? Well, the reason is that the chuck has gone AWOL, it's missing, and yeah, this thing is broken. So yeah, that's why I've been drilling by hand. Here is a status update. I have now drilled over half of the holes, and I think I'm actually gonna stop the video right here because, yeah, it's just a bunch. It would just be footage of me drilling. But yeah, so right now, once I have completed this plate, I will continue with the plate that is going on the engine or the motor. Habits die hard. And yeah, the plan is that once these two plates are done, we will drill a hole in the middle on both plates, and there will be sort of a tube section that comes out and joins these two plates together. But I have also taken the Fiat Multipla clutch disc that I bought. I can put up a short video here what it looked like. Big shout out to Damien. I watched one of his videos and he there stated that the Fiat Multipla clutch disc was a perfect fit, or very close perfect fit for this one. So I have that clutch disc and the clutch disc that is normally on this SR6 gearbox. They are at a machine shop, so I am waiting for this joiner piece to be completed. But once that's in, I will make a whole new video on how to mate these two boxes. So yeah, massive thanks to all my Patreon supporters. This build wouldn't be possible without you. So yeah, See you in the next one. Bye.